Well, I cannot speak on behalf of SASCOC. The nominations came from the provinces, and the provinces had to lobby, the provinces had to choose, and the process was as clean as it was supposed to be, and people were asked to come in to sign and see whether everything is there. So if they say that SASCOC will be the best person to answer, but from athletics, this was not an interference from SASCOC. They were not even here. You heard the IAAF delegate acknowledging SASCOC assistance and the government of the Republic of South Africa assistance.
I wouldn't stretch it as far as that. I think what is important is that we work with all stakeholders, SASCOC included. We cannot work against SASCOC. The sport will not succeed at all. We need to work with stakeholders such as SASCOC, but at the same time, we cannot be anybody's lapdog. I think it's important for athletics to be independent and work with stakeholders rather than be in the pocket of any stakeholder.
Well, who's SASCOC, by the way? This is the South African Sports Confederation. I don't even know where they sit, where's their offices. So I can't really make accusations that it is a SASCOC imposed. All I can say is that people played their hand. They obviously, in an election, you talk to people, so people have been talking to people. They were talking to people they know. I talked to a few people as well, but they don't know who I am. So it's like, oh, so you're Steve Mkasi, we saw your name, you're also standing. But who are you? You know, so I had my work cut out. When I was nominated, the one journalist I spoke to asked me what I was, whether I was hopeful to win. I said, if I get two votes, one from the SANDF and one from the SAPS, I'll be happy. But it seems to me there are more people who see value in me. So I will continue pushing for a clean administration. I will not stop today.
I would like to pay due tribute to the 7-member ad hoc committee, which has demonstrated both competence and dedication in the conduct of the very difficult and challenging mission it had been tasked with. I was particularly impressed with the transparent manner in which all their tasks have been accomplished, very often at their own personal expense. And I hope that the newly elected board will consider the possibility of offsetting some of the expenses they have incurred.
I believed in one thing. We can differ. We must not stop you from saying what you believe in. Say it here. Come to the meeting and say it. If we agree with you, we agree with you. If we don't understand you, we must be able to say we don't understand you. And I'm saying my leadership style, most of the people know, I don't dictate. I want a view from you, and I want somebody to comment, and I want us to reach a consensus in order for us to move forward. It's not always voting that will solve problems. Consensus of opinions that will always solve the problem. And we have reached at that point in time. With our board, we have to do that. Nobody should be bigger or stronger. Nobody should be stronger or bigger. So said Animal Farm, some animals are more equal than others. We are all elected by the same council, and we must account to the council in order for this sport to grow and come out from the bondage of shame that you all know to a better athletic South Africa. And we want to reclaim our position in Africa. Whether it's 2 years or not, we are not worried about our term, but we are worried about stability. We are worried about peace. We are worried about unity. And we are worried about progress and development of athletics at the lowest level. We can do all those things. But the question is, will those things make athletics to be better off? Will it make our athletes be able to go to the Commonwealth Games? Will those things make our athletes to prepare for the World Championships next year? Will those things help our athletes to go and prepare for the Olympics? So we need to be strategic and stay focused to our core business. Whilst those things are happening, we will need to focus in our core business, which is to run athletics in a proper way and assist athletes. And of course, it is our responsibility to get the top gurus in terms of finances, the auditors, the accountants, who are going to look at our books so that we don't have the repeat of the situation that you are alluding to. Corporate governance is critical. But I spoke earlier on, I've said you need a chief financial officer who will know what he is doing. But you also need the external people who are also going to come in and look at what is happening inside ASA. Once we do that, we will be on the correct path.
To those who won, I would recommend to be inclusive in their methods and to keep their contenders who lost on board. To those who lost, I would recommend sportsmanship and loyalty to those who won so that they can deserve the inclusiveness we've been calling for.